we're going to look at the top 5 must-have AI tools in 2024. With these tools, you can edit videos like a pro. You can eliminate repetitive and boring copying and pasting. You can improve your writing. You can analyze documents like a data scientist. And you could also up-level your video conferencing game. I'm sure at least one of these tools will change the way you work. Let's check these out. First up, I partnered with an amazing AI-powered video editing app called CapCut. And let's be honest, video editing can take so much time, skill, and also creativity. And sometimes I just don't have enough of those. CapCut is an extremely powerful and also easy to use video editing app that's free to use. CapCut has all of the core video editing functionality that you would expect, but what makes it stand out from other video editing apps is its extensive use of AI. For example, you can create a video directly with AI. Simply type in some text describing the video that you want, and then CapCut generates a script, a voiceover, and even matching images. You can also take an existing long-form video, and CapCut will automatically convert it into a short that you can upload to, say, TikTok or Instagram. It adjusts the aspect ratio, but it also keeps the subject in frame, and it even adds captions. Within the editing experience, you'll find a wide variety of AI tools. For example, you can remove the background of a video and replace it with any image or color that you want. And you can do all of that without even needing a green screen. You can correct and enhance the color of your video, making it more vivid and also appealing. You can also upscale the resolution and quality of the videos, even if the original was blurry or low quality. You could even add cool effects, and this one's really fun. You could put in transitions or 3D cartoons, manga, pop, and so much more. You can also relight a scene. Maybe your lighting wasn't ideal when you first filmed. You could position the light exactly where you want it, and look at how it interacts with the person. It's kind of like having a 3D object in a scene. You can also reframe. Here, I have a video filmed in landscape, but when I click on reframe, it automatically detects where the subject is, and then it locks on that in vertical form. You could even refine the way you look using AI. For example, I can smooth out my skin or whiten my teeth, and there are so many other improvements, and boy, I could sure use some of them. CapCut also has a number of AI tools to enhance the audio of your project. You can automatically generate captions from audio, and it'll even style them for you. You can enhance a voice and isolate a voice. Here's a video of me speaking on an airplane with lots of background noise.
Where are we right now?
We're at the airport.
When I turn on voice isolation, it automatically removes all of that background noise.
We're going 2 airplanes, and this is our last airplane we're going in.
It's really kind of like magic. You can also improve how you speak by having AI identify and then remove all of those annoying filler words like and ah. And this one is one of my favorites. You can also just change your voice into another voice. For example, I can speak as a werewolf, and I can even set it to a song.
This is the Stratvert YouTube channel. Be sure to subscribe.
To get CapCut, head to the website in the description down below, and then you can install it on your PC, or you could even use it directly on the web. Next up, we have UiPath Clipboard AI. If you spend any amount of time copying and pasting data from one application to another, you'll want to use this. Here, I have an image of data that I need to get into Excel. I'll copy this using Clipboard AI and then paste it into Excel, and it pastes all of the details, even the handwriting. You could even paste it into a pre-formatted table, and it pastes all the data into the correct columns. This is an insane time saver, especially if you routinely copy and paste lots of data between applications. Not only that, but you can also copy a text-based message, and it'll understand all the data from within the message, and then you can paste that into the correct columns too. My mind is blown. You could even use it to copy a table of data in Excel and then use it to paste into a web form. If you do any type of boring copying and pasting, this is kind of like having your own personal wizard that can save you from all of that. To get this free tool, head to the website in the description. Next up, we have Grammarly, an AI tool that can help you with all parts of your writing. You can use it to brainstorm new topics, outline ideas, revise your writing, and even polish it. It's like having your own personal proofreader and editor follow you around every time you write. Here, for example, I need to write an invitation to a company party. I can ask Grammarly to assist me with this. I can even use Grammarly to refine the message, like, let's make the invitation a little more fun and maybe a little bit more humorous. As I type, I also get real-time suggestions with improvements to up-level my writing. The thing I love about Grammarly is you can use it in any of the tools or places where you happen to work, like on Windows or Mac, in apps like Word or PowerPoint, or even on websites. You could also use it on iOS or even on your Android phone. Head to the website in the description and you can get Grammarly. Next up, we have OpenAI's ChatGPT, and it can help you with just about anything. At a very basic level, ChatGPT is your AI assistant. You can ask it a question, get an opinion, or even ask it to code or analyze data. And it does a pretty darn good job. For example, write a short song about the Kevin Cookie Company. Nice. More recently, you can now access something called the GPT Store, which extends the power of ChatGPT, as long as you have a premium membership. For example, here's an app called Consensus, and it'll analyze thousands of peer-reviewed and also published papers. For example, how old is the universe? You can also get access to something called the Data Analyst. Here, I'll drop in an Excel file, and it'll analyze it for me. Look at those interesting insights. I could even ask it questions. That's so valuable and also easy. You can even use it to generate images, like make a product shot of a box of Kevin Cookie Company chocolate chip cookies. Ooh, that looks good. We'll use that on our website. You can even turn a photo of yourself into a cartoon image. These are just a few examples of what you can do. You can get ChatGPT at the website in the description down below. And if you want some more advanced features, you'll have to go premium. Last up, we have an AI-powered tool called NVIDIA Broadcast, and you can use it to up-level your video conferencing game. As you know, joining a Zoom or a Teams meeting can sometimes be challenging, especially when you have to deal with things like background noise, or maybe poor lighting, or low-quality cameras and microphones. Or maybe you just want to hide the messy room behind you or add some cool effects to your video. With NVIDIA Broadcast, you can improve your audio quality. For example, you can remove unwanted noise from your microphone, such as keyboard clicks, maybe fan noise, or maybe you have a barking dog. You can add virtual backgrounds or blur effects to any camera, all without using a green screen. You can auto-frame your face, and it'll follow your movements. That way, you stay in focus and also in frame. Now, this one's a little creepy. You can have it keep your eyes in focus while you speak. Best of all, you can output the footage to any other application, like OBS or Zoom, Discord, or Microsoft Teams. It's kind of like having a professional studio directly in your home. You can head to the website down below in the description, and you can use this for free as long as you have an NVIDIA RTX graphics card. All right, well, hopefully you learned at least one new tool that will improve your workflows. Let me know down below in the comments, do you have any other AI tools that you recommend? To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I hope to see you in the next video.